I'm sure, Ikhwan, there is not one of you يعني, who is here as a Muslim, except that he recognizes, Ikhwan, that Allah Azza wa Jal alone deserves to be worshipped. There is not one of you except that he recognizes that Allah Azza wa Jal is one. There is not one of you except that he understands that it is by way of earning the good pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal that Allah will enter an individual into Jannah. But oftentimes, Ikhwan, the affair of Tawheed, first and foremost, is misunderstood. Secondly, oftentimes we find the affair of Tawheed being an issue, Ikhwan, that is neglected or that it is not given its true and due right. And Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions that which is related to Tawheed, the Tawheed of Allah Azza wa Jal, and the fact, Ikhwan, that Tawheed is not just a topic that is discussed and studied and then we get some understanding of it, and being people of Sunnah, we need to know it. And likewise, it is from the hot topics now that we hear going around and on the lips of the Muslims, so we should be acquainted with it. La. The Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ikhwan, it is the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The whole of the deen is Tawheed. And on top of that, the whole of the Quran, as Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah mentions, the whole of the Quran is Tawheed. And so, Ikhwan, it is ajeeb. And it is strange and amazing indeed that we hear people oftentimes saying, Tawheed, Tawheed, Tawheed. You know, when are we going to move on to another topic? When are we going to move on to something else? Tawheed, Aqeedah, you know, let's move on. Ibn al-Qayyim explains how, Ikhwan, Tawheed is the whole of the deen. And how the whole of the Quran is around Tawheed. He mentions, rahimahullah ta'ala, that when we analyze the Quran, we see that the Quran, Ikhwan, from its beginning to its end, is either verses wherein Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a matter of fact, before we get into the kalam of Ibn al-Qayyim, Ikhwan, how many categories of Tawheed are there? Barakallahu feekum, huh? Three. Anybody dispute with that, Ikhwan? Three. Jazakumullah khair. Tayyib. And they are? Tawheed al-Rububiyya. Tawheed al-Uluhiyya. And Tawheed al-Asma'i wa-Sifat. Tawheed al-Rububiyya, Ikhwan, when we say Tawheed al-Rububiyya, what are we exactly speaking about? Huh? Tayyib, Lordship. What do we mean by Lordship? You come across an individual, non-Muslim, he said, listen, I've read one or two of your books, and, you know, they're interesting, but just explain to me this Rububiyya. You know, explain to me this Tawheed al-Rububiyya that you speak of. How is it? How do we understand it? What exactly is it? And, you know, because I'm unclear. What is Tawheed al-Rububiyya, Ikhwan? Huh? Aywa.
Allah created us, provided for us.
Aywa. And leave us without purpose. Aywa. That, from the meanings of Rububiyya, is that we believe that Allah Azza wa Jal is the one creator. And that we believe that Allah Azza wa Jal is the one that sustains us. Huh? That Allah Azza wa Jal is the Malik, yani the one that possesses the creation. Huh? That we single Allah Azza wa Jal out with his actions. Huh? That ahsant, Allah Azza wa Jal gives life and takes life. So that and those are from the meanings of Rububiyya. So when we say Allah is the Rabb, and that he has from his rights is Tawheed al-Rububiyya, that is that we say and that we believe that Allah is the Malik, the Khaliq, the Mudabbir. That Allah Azza wa Jal has created everything that exists. And that Allah Azza wa Jal possesses everything in creation. And that Allah Azza wa Jal arranges the affairs within his creation. Tayyib. Question then, if that is what we're saying concerning Tawheed al-Rububiyya, how do we understand the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَتَبَارَكَ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. How do we understand the statement of Allah? So glory be to Allah, the best of the creators. The creators. Plural. When we're saying the oneness of Allah in his rububiyyah, from his rububiyyah is creation, that he alone has created. Yet still we find here Allah Azza wa Jal establishing creators. Huh? Ahsant. Anybody else? Anybody else, Ikhwan? How do you understand that?
Really, people who used to make the idols or any such sort of earthly things.
Anyone?
Pictures of people or whatever. They're sort of trying to be creators in the earth. But Allah is the best of creators because He made them.
Ahsant. That Allah Azza wa Jal, in actuality, when we're saying that Allah Azza wa Jal is the one creator, as our brother mentioned, we're saying, Ikhwan, and the difference between that which Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned from the creators, that the other creators, is that anyone else that creates or brings something into existence doesn't in actuality create. Rather, he changes something from one state to another. Whereas Allah Azza wa Jal is the one creator, the only one that creates something from nothing. And so, Ikhwan, when we say that Allah Azza wa Jal is alone in regards to the rights of creation, we're saying that Allah alone has brought the creation into existence. Anyone else does nothing but change things from one state to another. طيب. So, Tawheed al-Asma'i wa Sifat, what do we mean by that, Ikhwan? I think that we're clear, inshallah, as far as Tawheed al-Rububiyyah is concerned. Tawheed al-Asma'i wa Sifat, huh? Huh? Names and attributes. So what do we mean? What do we understand? We understand this. Now. Tawdhal. All the 99. Does Allah have 99 names alone? Huh? No. Allah has more than 99 names. But what about the hadith then? That the Messenger of Allah said, as occurs in Sahih al-Bukhari, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ تِسْعَةً وَتِسْعِينَ إِسْمًا مَنْ أَحْصَاهَا دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. That verily Allah has 99 names. Whosoever encompasses them, يعني memorizes them, acts upon them, then he enters Jannah. Well, here you are saying it's more than 99. Hmm. Aywa, ahsant. That the Messenger of Allah didn't say there are only 99 names. Allah, he mentioned that Allah has 99 names. Whomsoever memorizes those 99 from his names, then he'll enter Jannah. Whoever memorizes them, acts upon them, understands their meanings, and acts in accordance with them. And so, Ikhwan, Allah Azza wa Jal, in the Quran alone, there are more than somewhere in the region of 120 names of Allah Azza wa Jal, and there are more, no doubt, present in the ahadith al-sahiha and in the authentic sunnah. طيب, so tawheed al-asma'i wa sifat, that afwan, ayo, to single Allah Azza wa Jal out with his beautiful names and his lofty attributes, which means, anybody have any tafsil or further detail? Aywa, that we affirm what Allah Azza wa Jal affirmed for himself and what the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam affirmed for him. And that we believe that no one is more knowledgeable concerning Allah than Allah. And that we believe that nobody is more knowledgeable concerning Allah from the creation of Allah than the Prophet Alayhi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. طيب. And so we describe Allah with that which he describes himself with, and that which he described, or that which his Messenger ﷺ described him with, without making takyif, which is without saying how Allah Azza wa Jal's names and attributes are. What do we understand from that? It's not by the intellect, but how do we, when we say we don't say how the names and the attributes are,